Thanks for joining in today. It doesn't matter where you are, as long as you're meeting together with God's people and hopefully a few brand new people to the kingdom of God, and you're just curious about learning about God, thanks for joining in. It means a lot. And this session today, we're going to talk about a topic that is not popular, but so very vital to our walk with God and succeeding in life. And the topic is humility. Now let's go through our five B values again, which we consider our core values at House of Prayer, and we live by them. Everything we do are by these five values. So everything we put our hands to are these five values. We do them with that culture and with that spirit and that character trait. The first one is be prayerful, be loving, and then the one we're talking about today, be humble, and then be generous and be disciplined. So being humble means a lot of things to a lot of different people. Some people think if we just tear ourselves down, we're humble. If we have no confidence at all, we're humble. But clearly that's not it. God wants you to be confident, just confident in Him. Confident in your abilities with Him empowering them. Not, you know, an insecurity is not humility. And we get very confused on that. When someone says, I can do this, you know, and they have the confidence of Christ, and then people think they're arrogant. They think they're, oh my goodness, they think they're so much. And it's very discouraging, and people get very confused, especially in the church. We feel like if we have confidence that we can do something, that maybe we're being prideful. And I warn you about that. That's a trick of the enemy to get you to shrink back from your true calling, to not step out in faith and confidence in God, not running over people, not lifting yourself up higher than people, just simply contributing in the best way you can because you have confidence in God. That's true humility. I heard one person say, humility is not thinking less of yourself, but not thinking of yourself at all. I think true humility is when you become so God and others focused that you function from a sense of from that purpose, where you're so concerned about the cause of God and the needs of people, you're not really thinking about yourself. I think that's what humility will really do in your life, and it'll call the grace of God. So let's get into some scripture. James, the fourth chapter, I want to read 10 verses here, 1 through 10, in the New King James Bible. Hopefully you brought your Bible, notebook, and you're one of those kind of students. I was never a note taker in college, but I have learned that if you don't write things down, you tend to forget it, and you tend to be a little disorganized. So maybe if you haven't tonight, maybe next time, you can bring a notebook and bring a Bible, but let's go to the Word. James 4, 1 through 10 says, where do wars and fights come from among you? Do they not come from your desires for pleasure that war in your members? You lust and do not have. You murder and covet and cannot obtain. You fight and war. Yet you do not have because you do not ask. You ask and do not receive because you ask amiss. You're asking the wrong way. You're asking for the wrong purpose. And it tells you why right here, that you may spend it on your pleasures. Adulterers and adulteresses, that's so strong. Do you not know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Now, before I go any further, adulterers, adulteresses, yes, there's a literal sense of that word, but there's also a spiritual sense of that word where, yeah, we're in covenant relationship with God, but we also have a side chick called the world. Or a side dude called the world. And so we may party on Friday, but church it up on Sunday and think we're okay. But really, spiritually speaking, God considers you an adulterer or an adulteress because you're in a covenant relationship with the world and with pleasures of the world. But also, you're trying to be in a covenant relationship with God. Serious, serious stuff here. God's dealing with our sin issues. So I'm just like, ouch, God convict me, I want to change. Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. Now, this is very contrary to some of the big church world. I'm not against big churches. I think every church should be a big church because it means they're winning people to Jesus. But whenever we have to make friendship with the world to where you can have a preacher be friends with Hollywood and all of their sin, and his preaching doesn't offend them, what it is he's not preaching the true gospel. So his gospel only gives the blessings of God without ever giving the requirements for those blessings. And what we have is kind of a false sense of godliness in the world. And he's warning us here friendship with the world will make you, it will set you in opposition with God. So whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. Or do you think that the scripture says in vain, the spirit who dwells in us yearns jealously? So look, the spirit in you is going to get jealous if you keep giving yourself to the world. We all know how strong jealousy can be. But he gives more grace, therefore, he says. God resists the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. Now we're talking about pride and humility, because this is the key to our issues with sin and our relationship with the world and God and that struggle there. The issue is pride. It's at the center of this conversation, and the healing answer to that is humility, and we all must strive for it. And it's one of those weird things. It's like we're scared to say, I'm humble, because isn't that bragging and isn't that prideful? And it's so difficult to really grasp humility, but I think it's found from our relationship with God and lowering ourselves and lifting up God and then lifting up his purposes in the world. We just naturally live in a way that exudes humility. So humility really cures worldliness. Humility is the answer to our struggle with worldliness, where we act like the world, where we behave like the world that doesn't please God. And God is calling us to humility. In one scripture, he says, put on humility. He's not talking about put on a fake humility. He's saying, make sure every day you're clothing yourself with humility and not letting your pride rise up. Because you have it, you have to deal with it every day. And if you choose humility every single day, God's grace will always be in your life. And I love these last closing verses. I think this will help you. It says, therefore, submit to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. I want that kind of power. Draw near to God, and he will come near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners. That means everything you're doing that's wrong, cleanse it. Purify your hearts, because that's where it really comes from, your thoughts and desires and your will inside, your emotions inside. Purify that. You double-minded, lament and mourn and weep. Let your laughter be turned to mourning and your joy to gloom. Why? Because godly sorrow leads to repentance or change. That godly sorrow, that conviction will help you live right. It says, humble yourselves in the sight of God, and he will lift you up. Now think about that. Get under God, humble yourself to God, and he will lift you up. We all want to be lifted. The question is, are you going to lift yourself, or are you going to let God lift you up? Humility is trusting God will lift you up, lowering yourself to the place where God can lift you up. So this is what I'll say to you. According to James 4 and many other scriptures that we don't have time to go over today, humility is the antidote to worldliness. It's the antidote. What's the antidote? A medicine taken or given to counteract a particular poison. That's what an antidote is. You see, when Adam and Eve ate of the fruit, they were poisoned, and we needed an antidote for it. We needed Jesus's blood, his spirit living within us. And you want to know how Jesus acted? He was meek and he was lowly. He said, learn of me. I'm meek and I'm lowly. See, when we have humility, it keeps killing the virus in us called pride. And it's in us, and it's the greatest plague in the world. Some of you need a pride quarantine. We need to just shut out all the things that feed pride in us and really feed ourselves the Word of God and through prayer, the humility of Jesus. God gives grace to the humble. Now, many people don't understand grace. Grace is God giving you the good things that you don't deserve. So when you're humble, God brings things in your life that you didn't even work for and didn't even earn. Why? Because you had the nature of God. And when you please God with your nature, your new nature, the nature of humility, God puts things in your life that you don't even deserve. That's living in the grace of God. That's how you found salvation, and that's how you'll find all the blessings that God has for you. Mercy is just God not giving you the bad judgment you deserve. But grace is God pouring into your life all the things you really want. Now, he said to get it, you've got to submit to God. Submission is kind of a tester of whether you really have humility. The best definition I ever heard of submission is just breaking down the word sub, meaning under, mission, the mission of God. When you submit, you're getting under the mission of God's. So when every day you're finding out what God wants to do and you get under that, you're going to submit yourself and you're going to lower yourself and you're going to walk in humility and watch what God will do for you. God has inspired me to write a book, I think mainly for my own learning on humility because I need it so bad, and God is helping me grow in it every day, and it's blessing my life more and more as I learn God's ways. But we don't know exactly what we're going to call it yet. We've thought of the mark of the least, but one of the chapters and possibly a book title is named Humility. Play on the words humility and key, because I believe humility is the key that unlocks the door of all of God's blessings, all of God's callings, all of God's power. It's humility, which I call humility. I hope this blesses you. I hope the discussion really ignites a fire in you to study humility and to begin practicing it to the best of your ability from your heart, not just in your actions. Be doers, not just hearers. God wants a deep understanding of this, and He's going to bless your life. Have a lot of fun.